elaborate on my position. Could y'all please play the tape of Skip Bayless talking a few weeks ago, please, when he was talking about the Baltimore Ravens? Could you play that for our audience, please?
I got the Ravens losing their last 7 in a row. They got 2 games against Pittsburgh. They got to go to San Diego, to Washington. They got Denver, the Giants, and at Cincinnati. I think they could get on a negative roll and lose all 7 and miss the playoffs. I realize I'm way out on the limb on this, but I have the courage of my convictions, unlike others on this show. Do I get to respond to that?
Let me tell you what.
Wait, you brought it up. Do I get to respond right here, right now, before you go off on your soliloquy? Do I?
No, because
how close was I calling that exactly right? What happened at Pittsburgh? Roethlisberger was hurt and Leftwich immediately got hurt.
Skip,
what happened
skip,
in San Diego? Wait a second. If you're going to throw it at me, I'm going to throw it right back
you're
at
being
you.
Weak.
Wait.
You're being weak.
No,
you're being weak. Because,
do
that's not where, because that's not where I was going.
Okay,
that's
they almost lost 6 of their last 7. It took an uncalled block in the back on 4th and 29 at San Diego for them to win that game. Did they lose 4 of their last 5? Yes, they did. It was almost 6 out of 7. Did I almost come close to an incredible call? You better believe I did. Have you ever seen a team lose 4 of its last 5 and get on this kind of Super Bowl roll? I have not.
Are you finished?
No, you brought it up. I'm finishing what you started.
Well, you don't know what I brought up because you didn't let me make my point because you were so sensitive.
No,
to
I'm not sensitive. I'm just going
to
defend myself.
You're reacting to the wrong point that I was trying to make. Maybe if you let somebody make their point first, you would have known where I was going. I was waiting for that last line about the courage of your convictions because it was bringing me to the Patriots. In other words, what I'm saying to you is, I don't want to hear about Aqib Talib. I don't want to hear about Gronk. I don't want to hear about anybody because you started off the year before a game was played, before an injury took place, you said the Patriots. Throughout the season, you said the Patriots. No matter what hiccups they went through, you said the Patriots. Going into yesterday, you said the Patriots. So what I was trying to say, and you just took the fun out of it because you're so sensitive, because Lord knows, God forbid that Skip is actually wrong about something. You want to overreact to the point that I was making, and that wasn't even a point. I just wanted to get on you about the courage of your conviction. I wanted to get on you about the courage of your convictions, that one line. Because I tried to tell you, Tom Brady, whether it's him tap dancing, Wes Welker and the rest of the crew, whether it's them tap dancing, you can talk all of this stuff about the Patriots if you want to, but what you're missing is that the Ravens was putting some real heat on them all afternoon long. The hits that they were putting on the Patriots softened them up, and that's why they couldn't do anything in the second half. It got to the point where they had alligator arms, for crying out loud. They were scared to death. It was like that. When you put that kind of heat on somebody, it's all right to sit there and catch people off guard, to do trick plays, to be so cerebral, so brilliant, from Belichick to Brady on down, that you sit up there and you use that level of intellectual prowess to take advantage of another football team. But when you go up against some real heat and somebody put it on you, I mean really put it on you, all of a sudden, you get a little woozy. And that's what you saw with Tom Brady and the Patriots yesterday. They ran into a defense that sat there and said, we are going to make you feel our presence all afternoon long. We're going to put a hat on you. We're going to put some heat on you. We're going to make sure you understand this is a football game. This ain't flag football. Enough of this nonsense. And that's what happened. So we look at Tom Brady once again not producing against the Baltimore Ravens. We know he's great. We know he's a future Hall of Famer. We know we saw people on TV yesterday call him the greatest quarterback in NFL history. But it didn't look that way, as you adroitly pointed out, in the fourth quarter. Why? Because in the game of football, when it's time, this ain't the Jets, the Buffalo Bills, or the Miami Dolphins in the AFC East. This is some real football team that he went up against yesterday, and that's what happened. That was my point.
So why would you bring up that I said they would lose their last 7 straight? How does that apply to your point?
It applies to my point because what you were not taking into consideration is the fact that, again, all they needed was 1 or 2 victories to get in, which is exactly what they did. And once you get in, it becomes playoff football, and it's a different beast that shows up. You were sitting there and judging them based on what you were seeing weeks ago, which I understand. But again, I was saying to you, what have I been saying to you about the Patriots all year long? I talked about Tom Brady tap dancing. I talked about them being relatively soft. And I said when they run into somebody that's going to put some heat on them, it's going to be a different story. And this team with the what? Plus 25 turnover ratio committed 3 turnovers yesterday. Baltimore committed none. Something like that happens when you get some heat put on you.
Okay,
that's
now,
what I'm
now
saying.
To your point, that had absolutely nothing to do with that footage of me saying they'd lose 7 in a row. I
to
agree
me,
with
did.
You. The Ravens have owned Tom Brady and his offense, what, the last 5 or 6 times they played? He has played worse against nobody the way he's played terrible against the Ravens, Stephen A. And they don't try to trick him. They give him his pre-snap reads. They just stay right where they are. You know what they do? They win every battle at the line of scrimmage. Every defensive back wins the battle with the receiver. And they do. They beat him up. They push him around. They knock him off their spots. They eventually knock Brady off his spot, although I didn't think they put that much pressure on Brady yesterday. He had time, couldn't find anybody, and he unraveled in the fourth quarter. And again, Ridley had the one fumble.
They put pressure on everybody else. If you've got a bunch of cats around, if you got a bunch of cats around you that are softening up because they're getting hit, all of a sudden, where does that leave Brady? Because again, Brady had an opportunity. He could have scrambled for a first down. Elodinato was going after him. It looked like he could have outran him. One would think for that first down, but Brady got a little nervous himself.
Okay,
which is what I said with Gregory Hines.
Okay.
I tried to tell you.
But in the end, would it have helped to have Gronkowski? Yeah, it would have helped.
Yeah.
Would it help to have a physical Tlaib on the beast that is Anquan? Yes, it would have helped a lot. It would have changed the game.
But here's the last question.
And by the way.
But here's the last question.
Yeah.
Did you know they didn't have Gronk when you picked him?
Yeah. But am I going to back off my preseason pick? No.
Yeah,
I told you it was going to be a close game. I said it would be a field goal game.
Oh, it wasn't a close game. They got blown out.
I guess you could say 28-13 is blown out. But in the end, I mean, hey, Stephen A., they cashed 4 straight times in the red zone, 4 touchdowns. Brady got 1 touchdown in 4 trips. That's the ball game. Thank you.